Well, here we are. Or, well, 80s movies, in case you didn't know, in case you're new. We talk about 80s movies, be them great or not. And we're here on our 7-year anniversary.
Wow. 7 years.
7 years of talking about movies. I know. Movies. Movies, I would say, at least 70% that I didn't even know existed. Okay, maybe not quite 70%, but a huge chunk.
A lot of these, most if not all of these, I knew existed. Mm. The ones that I haven't seen, it has to be 50% at least.
Yeah. We should do some math on that, maybe. I don't know. We're both pretty lazy.
There's 185 things to go through.
Wow. That's a lot. 185 episodes. 7 years in. Well, happy anniversary.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you hear stomping?
I don't. Is there some stomping happening?
Yeah, I think somebody has to take a bath and they're not happy about it.
Oh, well.
Carla.
Carla's like, I hate taking tubbies.
She's like, tubbies? What's your problem?
Stomping around.
No, yeah, 7 years. I can't, you know, and I'll get like those little Facebook memory things.
Oh, those are
And
sweet.
I just got one for Little Darlings and it was like 7 years ago.
Our very first episode. We were so green then.
We didn't know what we were doing.
No idea.
Please don't listen to it because I would be afraid that it sounds exactly like what we're doing now. And
people be like after 7 years, there's zero interest.
This guy's like, I couldn't let whatever we discovered come to Earth. Because yes. I love how he's like, I wonder where I am. And he looks out the spaceship's window and sees Earth. And then realizes, uh-oh. So he's like, I just had to totally torch the place. And then I escaped to my little escape pod. Mm-hmm. And then he goes to bed and they watch him sleep, which I found very odd.
Yeah. Well, he's tired. And they keep saying, like, he's so tired. Can you just let him rest? He's so tired.
Remember that other guy we interviewed who was really tired?
Yeah.
This guy looks even more tired than he did.
We should let him rest a little bit. And so while he's resting, he has an insane nightmare where the girl, do we see it, right? Where the girl is coming to him and...
Yes. Yes. I mean, it is an insane nightmare. Insane sexy nightmare. Well, first it is scary because a giant fat pops out.
Yeah.
But then it turns into her. Finally, they put clothes on this woman for just a second. Mm-hmm. But she does have clothes on for just a brief minute in this movie.
But she comes to him. She wants them to exchange life again. Yep. Give me your life. And he's screaming. He wakes up. Which the screaming happens to even the corpses when they die and they turn to dust. Before they do, they let out these harrowing, awful screams.
Yeah. There's a lot of like noises in this track. There's like squeaks and squeals and screams and like sometimes I think baby noises. There's all sorts of stuff happening when these aliens are around.
Creepy as fuck. But he wakes up screaming and sweating.
Very sweaty.
But also now very aware of where she is and what's happening and what she's thinking and what they kind of have to do moving forward.
Knows
He's
everything.
Got all the information.
Mm-hmm. But never to the point where anybody's like, maybe we should lock you in a room for a little bit. Like, maybe.
No, they need to get to the bottom of this.
And he's like, at all turns, he's like, I know what she's thinking. I know where she is.
Well, first he's hypnotized. And I think that, like, awakens it. Because the white-haired man, after the nightmare happens, he's like, all right, we got to get into what the freak is going on in your brain. And you've given us some information, but not enough. So the white-haired man hypnotizes him. And in the hypnosis, he gets a lot of information from him that now she's in a new body, and he sees it all, and then we see it all.
Really,
she's a red-haired woman now who picks up some dude off the side of a road in his car, and he says, "I see a man. He's by his car. He's by the trunk of his car. He's kind of fiddling with the car." She sees him.
So
she gets
funny.
In the car with him. While they're in the car, she wants him to touch her leg. He is touching her leg. Oh God, he's touching her leg. This is how he's telling it, right?
Oh, yeah, he's telling it like that, but Jamie left out some great things, because while he's telling this, the inspector's like, do you know the make of the car? He's hold on, let me...
And the license plate looking. Number.
Oh, it's a Volvo.
Yeah.
All right, are you able to see the license plate? Oh, yeah, I can clearly see the license plate. And he puts down all the letters and numbers and then goes, it's either an H or an R. Yeah. Like, he's taking an eye
like
exam.
Like an eye exam, yeah. I don't know, H, R,
he's
but it's
so
in there.
Specific with
but it's
everything.
Great, because they want to actually track. If this is what he's seeing and it's happening in real time, they want to be able to track it. And so, yeah, so there's this alien woman he can connect to through this hypnosis, and he finds that she's taken over this other woman's body, and this other woman is about to probably take the life force from this man who owns this Volvo. And
also, they are solving this, and I understand. This is not an easy mystery to solve. Like, they have to get to the bottom of this, and it's going to take time. But while they're doing this, I'm like, that female alien's probably murdered at least 50 people. And all the time it's taken you guys to do this, she must be life-forcing half the rural population.
Well, we find that out to be, that it spreads.
And also, I love how at some point during this, one guy's like, also that giant alien spaceship, it's on its way to Earth.
Oh, yeah.
It's the most tossed off, because nobody reacts to that at all.
Yeah, it's coming here. Yeah, it's about to crash right into London. And this is also when the white-haired man is like, I have this sword, this amazing sword that will, it'll kill a vampire, and these essentially are that. So I just happen to have that. So
is this when, because a soldier interrupts him.
Yes.
He has this sword and he's like playing with it, and then evil music plays because the soldier comes in. I love later when they cut back to him and he's like, remember when I said these are vampires? These are totally vampires, because I just stabbed this guy with it and he's dead.
And it worked.
And only a vampire can be killed by a sword to the heart.
Where did you get this sword, white-haired man?
Why
I want more information.
Office,
I need more information. What are you studying exactly? Death. I think he says he studies death at one point, which kind of makes sense because it's life force. And
Again, very layered.
If you think about...
Go
ahead.
No, go ahead.
No, go ahead.
No, I just... He should have, like, some sort of actual title or actual area of study. Just saying, like, I study death and also vampires.
Right. And, I don't know, I'm just here because I've got a plethora of random knowledge that, you know.
Also, have you seen my hair?
Yeah.
Have you seen it?
It's
have you checked this out?
Yeah. Just that alone commands a certain amount of attention.
It really does.
But, this movie, if you think about it from different angles, it's can be very layered. Anyway, we're go to the high security hospital.
Why? This woman with red hair lives at a, for lack of a better word, mental hospital, right?
It's
run by Patrick Stewart.
Yeah, and then who's the other guy that they visit at the hospital? Because they so first they visit the red-haired woman, the guy, the chubby guy.
They go in. Patrick Stewart shows up in this movie and is like, what do you need? I will help you get whatever you need. You want the run of the place? And they go.
He hesitates a little bit.
It's an apartment.
Yeah. Because they're well taken care of, studied, I suppose, for their mental illness. They visit this red-haired woman who lives, like you said, in kind of her own little apartment.
Right.
And does this movie take quite a crazy turn here? So the commander is there. The Carlson is there.
There's the astronaut.
Mm-hmm.
What's his name?
Carlson.
Carlson.
You don't remember the naked lady? Carlson. Carlson.
Nope.
Come.
Nope.
Mm-mm. Come to me, Carlson.
Mm-mm.
Oh, well, she says it several times.
When naked ladies are talking, I am not paying attention to what they're saying.
Oh, jeez.
So he's there, and also the inspector, the police inspector, is there.
Mm-hmm.
And I guess Pocket Square's there, just hanging out with
Patrick
Stewart somewhere.
Yeah, just...
But it's just the two of them in this room with this redhead.
Mm-hmm.
And it gets crazy, because the astronaut's like, listen, I'm going to have to slap the shit out of her. And you're a cop. So if you're not into this, you better get out. But I'm doing it whether you say so or not.
Yeah, because
the cop is like, you know what?
I'm kind of into it.
See this.
He says. He really did I write is it like, down? I'm a natural this. Voyeur. I'm a natural yeah. voyeur, he says. And he sits down and crosses his legs like, let's get ready for the show. And the commander, Carlson, just starts to like yell at the woman and shake her. And what he's trying to do is inside of this woman is supposedly this alien creature's energy life force. And he's very angry. He's like, where are you? Come out. Let me go. He says many things to her. One of them is, and repeats himself a lot. Let me go. Let me go. Where are you? Where are you? Come
it's
on out.
Him
and
yelling.
She's got like a robe or she's got something on and he like violently strips her, not yes. totally naked, but naked enough. And right. is like in her face. And yes. she's got marks on her back, like something uh-huh. attacked her. But he yells at her directly in her face and shakes her for like a while.
A long while.
And a disturbing amount of time where you're like, why does he have to do this?
She kisses him?
Yeah.
Like, it is so weird.
Mm-hmm. But that's when he feels it.
In a movie full of weirdness.
And then doesn't he say, like...
Then she, like, passes out and he's just like, oh, I'll just lay you down right here. You're totally good now.
Yeah.
Because then he's... Because, again, it just seems like this guy's making this up as he goes. Because he's like, well, she jumped out of her. And now I know who she went into. And I'm like, you? Was it you? Because you're the only person.
Because you're the only person in contact with her, right.
You just kissed her the way she does to other people to take their life force. And now you're like, yeah, there's some maniac, some child murderer in the basement that she jumped into. Patrick Stewart, take us to him.
Yeah. Yeah, and he's Patrick Stewart's a little hesitant. He's like, I don't know. He's got the mental capacity of a 4-year-old. Do you really? And so we see this.
Well, first when he's like, can we do this another day?
Yeah, can they?
Good try.
He's like, it's kind of late, and these are my patients. And I mean, I'm going to let you do it, but maybe in the morning after some breakfast? And they're like, no, this is just kind of fucking after important. Like this.
You can stay here.
Yeah,
I got an extra upstairs. Room. Right? It's great. I come in around 9. I have a couple meetings, just staff meetings at the beginning of the day.
It's
but you
fine.
Know what?
We'll get rolling by 11. It's good.
Yeah, 11 yeah. after lunch tomorrow at the latest.
We'll get it. We'll get you on the books. But no. They want it now. And so he obliges. And they go to the downstairs to the basement into this padded room
yeah.
where this chubby guy is laying in bed, again, awkwardly screaming. And they're going to sedate him. They have
these,
or no, they have the hypnotic potion or something to put.
No, it's like truth serum.
Mm-hmm.
They're like, oh,
they're gonna inject him with it.
I like how to every turn when somebody's like, well, what if you kill him or something? How the inspector's always like, I will take full responsibility
yeah.
for anything that happens. Later on with Patrick Stewart, he's telling the other doctor like, get me all those drugs. I am taking full responsibility
yeah.
for this.
Yeah. He needs, he's
Never
investing, he needs to get to the
guy
bottom
flash
of it.
A badge in this movie.
Never. That's why I was like, is he a reporter with
yeah.
this trench coat? What is happening? He doesn't
he
look as official
at the
as he
of
is.
This movie and is like, I'm Inspector blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, none of you doctors want to see identification.
You
want to
make sure?
Nobody
yeah.
wants to see. There are space aliens running around and you're not going to at least have this guy open his wallet for you.
Well, so when they're getting ready to Patrick Stewart's getting ready to inject right. hesitantly inject the he's like, do we have to do this to this guy? I don't know. Do we really know for sure that this, are we gonna take this crazy commander? He just literally fell out of space. Do we really want to just say anybody he says to inject we should inject? And then they turn on him.
Sweating?
They go,
can we trust a man
who sweats this much? They turn on Patrick Stewart. They
right.
hold him down and inject him
right.
because
yeah.
the commander, Carlson, gets the vibe that she has now moved bodies
yeah,
once again.
Right. So here's where I have some questions about Carlson's real tie to this alien. Because when the alien jumps out of red hair, he's like, I know who she jumped into.
Mm-hmm.
It's a giant mental patient.
Mm-hmm.
And then later on, he's like, I knew it when Patrick Stewart touched my shoulder.
Oh,
I
yeah.
I could feel her inside there. And I'm like, well, so she
Why'd
lied
you
to
go
you.
Around all these other guys?
Right.
Yeah.
Well, no. It's not even so much that, but it's like, oh, so So the alien can trick you. So why do we need to believe you when you're like, I know where to go. I know where everybody is. I know exactly what's happening. I'm like, the alien lied to you very early in this movie and almost tricked you. And if it didn't fuck up with Patrick Stewart, I don't know, sexily touching your shoulder or whatever, you would not have known what's going on. I don't want to say that he should not be believed. We see how this movie ends, and it turns out fine. But I just did not trust him.
You don't trust him.
I really
him.
Thought he was going to end up being her at the end of this.
Oh.
I thought it was going to be a big thing, like a big twist where you're like, all the aliens are dead, all the space vampires are dead, everything's back to normal, and he gets in a room with the inspector and then like
and
turns
then
back into
her
or something.
Into her. Oh.
Yeah.
That's not what happened, but that would have been interesting.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah.